afternoon. I hope y'all are well. If we have not met, my name is Chris Carson. I am the pastor here at Riverside Presbyterian. It is my privilege and pleasure to welcome you as we gather together. I am looking out and seeing familiar faces, some of whom should have been here 5 hours ago. I'm keeping track, people. If this is your first time here, one of the outreaches we have as a church is we offer this concert series, and there's some more concerts still to go in the upcoming couple months during this series. As you know, it is a free concert. All of them are free. However, if you would like to donate, we are more than happy to allow you to do so, so that we can continue to provide these concerts. And even if you don't, we will still do so. But I know that people appreciate the opportunity to give back as well. And so at the end of the concert, there will be people outside the doors with buckets. If you want to put something in, great. Please don't take anything out. But put something in, and that would be wonderful. We have wonderful, wonderful police officers who support us here in Cocoa Beach. They are making a plea. And so this actually, I'm being serious. If you are going north when you leave today, if you could go out on that road over there between the church and the swim shop, whatever it is called, that would be great. It's just easier for them to stop traffic over on that side of the church. If you're going south, feel free to go out either exit. But if you're going north, they request that you go out on this side of the church over here. I hope that makes sense. I'm directionally impaired, so if you want more, you're not going to get more from me on that. Let's pray, and then I'll bring the Ditchfields out, and we'll just have an awesome time to celebrate this afternoon. Great and loving God, we thank you for today, for the chance to get together, to celebrate the gift of music, to celebrate a family that enjoys just being together, to celebrate a community that is excited about all the things that you are doing. We ask, Lord, that in this time you are glorified, and we would just have fun in your presence. In your name we pray. Amen. Thank you.
Afternoon. Good, we are so glad to see all of you. in Cocoa Beach, and we want to echo the words of the pastor that we have a wonderful police force here, and they're so helpful. However, we would like to have some words with your meteorologist. At least I think we're safe that we're not going to get any snow. But I'll tell you, we love coming over here, and we are still trying. This is, believe it or not, this is our 14th year. When we first started coming here, my hair was dark brown. That was really amazing. But, you know, there was 1 year we came over here, and we thought, now we're going to go to Cocoa Beach. So let's just take a look. We're going to go a day early. We'll check into a motel on the beach. We'll have a wonderful family time. Some of you remember that year. It was 31 degrees. It was sunny. But the door on the hotel room was frozen. And then other days we were here when it was so hot, and unfortunately the air conditioning went out. We had a really hot concert that day, and I'll tell you that. And then there was one time where we did have a beautiful sunny day, but the wind was blowing at, you know, somewhere between 40 and 50 miles an hour. It practically blew us all the way. But joking aside, we are so delighted to see you, and thank you so much to Riverside for inviting us back. It's something we look forward to all year. Just out of curiosity, how many of you have never seen the Ditchfield Family Singers before? Wow, quite a few of you. I guess I should ask them, how many of you were seeing us for the very first time? They always seem to be 50-50 here. I don't know, it's a little bit. Anyway, a lot of you have seen us, and thank you so much for coming to hear us again. Anyway, but since there are a lot of new folks, I thought what we might do is just take a couple of minutes and let the kids introduce themselves, because we are actually all one family. So, take it away.
Well, good afternoon. My name is Nathaniel, and this is my wife, Regina. And Gina and I celebrated 28 years of marriage this year. And as you all know, Valentine's Day is right around the corner, so we're all dressed up in red and ready to celebrate with you. Gina and I are the proud parents of four boys, one of which you're going to get to meet a little later. And as of this year, we also have three grandsons.
My name is Michael. I'm the middle son, and this is my wife, Taylor.
Thank you.
And next Sunday, we will be celebrating our 13th wedding anniversary. Thank you for applauding. Usually when I tell our Florida audiences how long we've been married, I just get blank stares. Or they look at me like, big deal, or so what, you know? I guess, you know, 13 years is still newlywed status in Florida. Has anyone been married 50 years or more? And that's why nobody claps for 13. In addition to almost 13 years of happy marriage, we do also have two beautiful children, Audrey and Amy.
My name is David. I'm the youngest son in the family. My wife, Katie, and I have been happily married for a whole 7 years. And Katie and I also have a little boy and girl, and their names are James and Lucy.
I'm Stephanie. I am the youngest daughter of the Ditchfield family, and everybody always asks me, where do you fit in the lineup? So I will tell you, I am younger than Nathaniel, and I'm older than Michael and David. And that's all you need to know.
When I was a young man, quite a few years ago, usually I say over 20 years and they all choke and gag back there, but it was some time ago, but I met a beautiful young girl, and she was unlike any other girl I'd ever met, ever. And in fact, so much so, 11 days after I met her, I proposed to her, and for some reason she said yes, and for which I am eternally grateful, and she has been with me through all of our life's journey, through our good times and our bad times, and she gave me this great lot, and for which we are also eternally thankful, and I can't imagine life without her, my beautiful wife, Bernice.
Thank you. Well, it was quite a few years ago that we met.
It was over 20 years, I'll tell you that. So.
A friend took me to their house, and he wanted me to meet his older brother. But his older brother was playing the organ, and he was singing. And he happened to be singing a Carpenter song, Close to You. And I didn't want him to be close to him. From then on, we were engaged 11 days later. And we now had our 50th wedding anniversary, and next week we're celebrating our 51st anniversary. And we know he didn't get married when he was 9, which he's fond of saying. But I fell in love with not only his voice, but the man that I saw before me. But this afternoon, you will have the privilege of hearing what I fell in love with. Beautiful voice of Stephen Ditchfield.
Thank you. Well, it is Valentine's Day, and we were kind of asked to do a love theme, which is okay for us because that's at the center of all we do. But if it's okay with you, I'd like to sing what I consider to be a Valentine's song tonight, Valentine. You remember the poet Browning, who said famously, "Grow old along with me, the best is yet to be." My arms won't free you.
Brace yourselves, it might get a little sappy.
We specialize in sappy.
So, my mom and dad celebrated their 50th last year. The kids, we put together a little surprise for them. And at their 50th party, we sang a song to them, which I think is the first time we've done that. And mom was saying that the first song she heard dad sing was the Carpenters' classic, Close to You. So you'll probably recognize this one.
Maybe I'm old-fashioned.
15, so there aren't a whole lot of kids that are really into barbershop quartet music. But fortunately, at his school back in Sarasota, they had a whole program for this. And so their kids are all getting excited about singing harmony and singing old songs together. So Timmy, you may have remembered over the years, he's grown up and up and had this beautiful high soprano voice. That one is gone.
Yes.
Right. He is now singing lead. So we're going to kick Michael off the stage and ask Timothy to come on out here. Timmy, you back there?
Take fire.
Here it comes.
You can't fire me, but quit.
And Timmy's going to sing a lead part on a song you'll probably be familiar with, but in the barbershop style.
Sometimes in the morning,
think you do remember that song. Oh, I thought you would, right? But you probably can't remember the last time you heard it. Well, there's another song that you're going to recognize, but it comes to us from a totally different place. If I was to say the term Rat Pack, would that mean anything to any of you? Yeah, of course, it was Frank Sinatra and the incredible Sammy Davis Jr. and Peter Lawford and Jimmy Bishop and Dean Martin. That's Simone, right? So, anyway, they were a remarkable group of talented men, but every now and then Frank and Sammy would get together and sing a song. And you know, we have two boys here that are, well, one of my goals when they were born was to try and raise them in such a way that they would appreciate one another, love one another. And I'm glad to say that they are best friends, have always been, and I think always will be. They're only 16 months apart. About 16 inches apart. I don't really know how that happened, actually.
16 IQ points?
Yeah.
Well, they're bright.
Yeah. Anyway, they are best friends, and in fact, they're pretty much inseparable. And they've got a wonderful Frank and Sammy song that they're going to do for you.
I'm shorter, I guess that makes me Sammy.
Like the wallpaper sticks to the wall, like the seashore clings to the sea, like you'll never get rid of your shadow, you will never get rid of me. Let all the others fight and fuss, whatever happens, we've got.
Movie. He's one of our favorites, a brilliant comedic actor, but really underrated with his singing and his dancing as well. And I think this is probably one of his most beautiful songs that he sang. The film I'm talking about was one, it was a period piece, it was a comedy, but it featured knights, and jousting, and pellets with the poison, and the vessel with the pestle, and the chalice from the palace as the brew that is true. The court jester. Yeah, it's one of our favorite movies, and this year we actually just showed that to our little ones, and that kind of is what jogged my memory, and I thought, you know what, I actually arranged that song, why didn't we ever do that? So anyway, here we are now, finally, after all these years, to bring this song to you, and we're going to feature Dad on this beautiful lullaby from The Court Jester.
Source of all love. The scriptures tell us, of course, that God is love.
And I'm reminded of the words of one of the most renowned contemporary theologians, a man by the name of Karl Barth. And he traveled and lectured all over the world, a true biblical scholar. One day he was approached by some folks, students who said, you know, Mr. Barth, what is the most profound spiritual truth that you have ever discovered in all your years and years of study? He thought for a second and he said, well, I'll tell you. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. And I always thought that was kind of neat. So we have some, they're not exactly theological scholars, but there's nothing more precious than hearing that particular song from some little people that we just happen to have some. She was kind of in the twilight of her career, and to sort of have one last go at it, they decided they now call a mashup. You know, where you sing two different songs at the same time. That's what a mashup is. Is that what it is? Yeah, okay. Just not sure. I never heard that. I always thought it was, you know, potatoes and gravy and stuff like that. But anyway, so they decided to do this song, and she brought this young singer on, and they created something that has become one of the most iconic moments ever recorded on film or for television. And that young singer was just 21 years old, and her name was Barbara Streisand. And they did this phenomenal mashup, and I know I'm related to them, but I don't think they sang it any better than what our very own Taylor and Katie do. You're going to really love this.
Some of those things. certain part of me.
Stars will smile.
urgency. We're about to take a brief intermission, but before we do that, we've got some wonderful music playing for you for the second half, some of our favorite songs and our most requested songs, but just a couple things to mention to you. Out there blocking the way to the restrooms is our son Timmy with our CD table, and we've had the privilege of recording, I think it's 6 different CDs over the years. We've got our family CDs, the Barbershop Quartet, Michael and Taylor, whose voices you've enjoyed this afternoon. They have a CD called Just the Two of Us. And we do things a little differently these days with our CDs. We used to sell them for $15 each. But these days, as we travel a little less and stay a little closer to home, it is really our hope and our joy that you've enjoyed our music and that you will take it home and enjoy it. So if you would like our CDs, we'd like you to take them. If you'd like to leave a donation to help cover the cost, that's great. If you didn't bring any money but you'd like to have the music, please take a CD home. If you have a neighbor that you think might enjoy it, or it could be a pick-me-up for them, take a CD and give it to them. We want you to enjoy that, and we hope that that's a blessing to you. And like I said, if you are able to do a donation, that's great. If not, we'd just like you to enjoy the music. So a couple other things I mentioned real quick. We do have a website, which if you type in our last name, Ditchfield, you'll find us right away, or it's ditchfieldfamilysingers.com. And you can check out where we're going to be and what we're up to and doing. And there's also, if you go on Facebook, we have some Facebookers in here, don't we? Yeah, we have quite a few. If you'd like to see some behind-the-scenes pictures and videos and what's going on, that's a great place to follow the family and watch all those little kids grow up as well. So we're going to take about a 10 to 15-minute break. We got a big second half ready for you, and we'll see you in a few minutes. Thanks so very much.
Doo-wop.
There's a possible problem.
Yes, we were actually, the RV that we were giving away for that is actually in the next show. So sorry. But anyway, back to doo-wop. There were tons of great groups like the Drifters, the Platters, the Temptations, and this particular piece was actually done by the Del Vikings. And for your listening pleasure, we're going to feature our curly redhead.
I'm
in 2023 to wish you a Merry Christmas. We actually beat Walmart this year, we did. So one of the things, one of our favorite music and types of music is Christmas music. We always do a lot of Christmas concerts. We used to do as many as 15 or 20 in the month of December. We've cut that back a little bit because it's kind of complicated taking this huge troop on the road. We still love Christmas music, and we're sorry that we don't often get to share it all with you because you're one of our very favorite audiences. And so we thought we'd do a Christmas song for you to get you in the spirit early for next year. Yes.
We need Walmart.
Yeah, we did. Absolutely, we did. So anyway, truthfully though, the message of Christmas is not really just for Christmas, is it? It's a year-round message. So we've done one of those mashup things, right? That's a match. We've done a kind of a mashup, a Christmas mashup. So all we need is turkey and some dressing, and it would be perfect. But anyway, we hope that you enjoy this one.
And what?
Sure, not only a divine blessing, but we can be sure of prosperity. You know, America's been through some very difficult times before. But if you're a praying person, this would be a really good time, okay, to be praying, because America sure needs some light from above. I think probably most of us would agree with that. So we'd like to close with a special song that's from America's most prolific songwriter. He wrote about 4,000 songs, and of all things, he was an immigrant. But he made this his homeland, and he loved America, and he wrote this song. This could be a bit of an interesting history. He wrote it for a show that was to be produced in 1918, and it was to help raise money for the armed forces. And the show was running too long, so he cut one of the songs, and he put it in his filing cabinet, and it sat there for 20 years, never saw the light of day. And then a young American singer by the name of Kate Smith said that she would really love to have something that would be appropriate for her Armistice Day show. Did he have anything? And he said, let me check. So he went back in that cabinet and he pulled out that 20-year-old dog-eared copy of a song that I guess kind of we always will associate Kate Smith's fabulous rendition of it. But it's from the heart of the great Irving Berlin, of course, and it's more than a song, it's really a prayer. So we're going to sing it through one time, and then we're going to ask all of you if you'd help us. And we're going to raise our voices, and we're going to continue to love one another, to love our country, to pray for one another, and to do what we can. You know, I can't do the things I did when I was 30. Can't do the things I did when I was 60. But anyway, I can still do something, right? And so that's what we need to do, is you do what you can and do the right, and it's always right to do the right thing. So from the bottom of our heart,